Hello everyone, Kenneth Steines here from Sensei. I'd like to share with you some of the ways our clients use Microsoft Teams to collaborate on projects, programs, and portfolios. With Teams, our clients have a single source of truth, automated reporting, and a central place for collaboration. In the example here, we have four teams. The first one is open to the entire organization. This is where we can see things like notifications of incoming proposals and an overview dashboard showing the progress of key projects in the organization and so on. The second team represents a program. Here we have the details of the program itself, as well as all the projects rolling up into it. Next is a team for the 2021 IT portfolio, where the channels represent the details and the programs and projects that are part of the IT portfolio. The last team here is for a project that requires its own security. Only members of the Microsoft 365 group behind this team have access to the details. Let's take a look at how an individual project is managed. I'll pick the Absolute Technology R400 infrastructure project under the acquisitions program. Each channel by default comes with a feed that summarizes activity on the project and enables the team to chat and collaborate easily. From the Files tab, we can access the documents for the project and have conversations about them in addition to co-authoring in real time. No more emailing documents. The backend is SharePoint, so you have the native version control and alerts and much, much, much more. OneNote is great for meeting minutes, vendor and procurement conversations, and anything related to the project. These notes are now searchable and available offline. On the next tab, the team can see the schedule and the tasks for the project. In this case, we're using Microsoft Project for the web, where the grid view shows the work breakdown structure for the project. The board view then shows the same tasks, but on different boards that can be grouped by bucket, assigned to, progress, and finish date. And the timeline view is the visual representation of where the tasks on the project are scheduled. Now, you can use just about any scheduling tool out there. We tend to see our clients use Project for the Web, Project Online, Azure DevOps, and Jira. Whichever you choose, you'll want to add a tab in your project channel for the tasks so you don't need to leave Teams to get to your work. If you choose to, your organization can apply a governance process to all projects for gated approvals and overall consistency in deliverables and reporting. If it looks familiar, that's because it's using the native process flow from Dynamics. The detailed justification and business case for the project should always be available for the team to refer back to. This helps to provide context and guide any decisions that need to be made during project execution. Your project may also have key dates, which are top-down dates that we want to report on to senior management. The project manager can capture the overall status of the project, typically weekly, through key performance indicators, as well as narrated details for each. A snapshot of the data at the time of statusing allows stakeholders to refer back to a previous point in time for the whole project. Risks, actions, issues, decisions, often referred to as RAID, are key collaboration elements on most projects. Rather than separate spreadsheets or disconnected tools, all RAID items can live centrally in Microsoft Teams and be available for reporting, alerts, reminders, approvals, and any other automation. Likewise, formal project change requests can be captured electronically and sent for digital approval with automated notifications and custom triggers. Again, we're trying to avoid sending documents via email and having offline signatures. From the Financials tab, approved budgets can be recorded, and the project manager can plan the spending and track actual costs on the project. This makes it easier to identify variances and report on the financial state of the project. Using Power BI, automated project status reports pull together all relevant information for the project. These reports can also be emailed automatically to your stakeholders on a regular basis through the subscribe option in Power BI. The reports typically go from a high-level status that summarizes the project to a more detailed view of the work with all the tasks, who's working on what, and so on. Project managers can also track variances and exceptions around all the collaboration details. And stakeholders can see the detailed financials for the project. If your organization is a Microsoft shop, you probably already have the tools you need to provide that centralized collaboration for your virtual project teams. And if you're not sure how to get started, please reach out to us at senseiiq.com or by following the links in the notes for this video.